congratulations, Bharat, for this great, gigantic leap which we have taken today. And Neha, whoever will dominate the space will definitely dominate the land. And we are moving in that direction only. And as far as India is concerned, we are, since we are the first country who is landing on the southern pole of moon, we are also, we are expecting water, and we are also expecting to find helium, helium-3, because once any country who find helium-3 and bring it here will definitely dominate the energy requirement of this globe. And we don't want to be a part of it, but we want to lead it. As far as you are asking about Pakistan, since Mr. Imran Khan is there in the United States, I'll request him, go to NASA and ask them that, are you fools that you have put your instrument in Chandrayaan-2?
Okay.
You should not forget that in Asia, there is a space race going on between us and China. And one should remember one thing, that future wars are not going to be fought on the land. They will be fought in the space. Once a satellite is down, your communication goes. Then all your weaponries and your aeroplanes and everything, the jets, they become useless. So India is having an edge on most of the countries. We are not only in the club of those countries who are possessing nuclear arms, but we are also in those, in the elite club of those countries which have got the capability to strike our satellite. So at this hour, we don't need to talk about Pakistan, because Pakistan is a very backward country as far as the science and technology is concerned. Let them live in their stone age, and let them even go behind that. With the kind of jihadi terrorism they are spreading, and we are moving much ahead of them. And our competitor is China, basically, not Pakistan.
I totally agree, Gulrez. On a day like today, we should really...